In this unit, we'll continue learning about the Internet Core and understand its functionality. The Network Core has two key functions. The first function is routing messages to their destination using a routing algorithm running on the routers. Every message online consists of two parts: the information itself, the data, which contains the information the message was sent for, and the top of the message, the header, which contains additional information, such as the transmitting point and the destination point, and the protocol the message was sent with. When a router receives a message and stores it in the queue, it reads the message header and runs a decision algorithm, which determines what line to export the message to. Every router has a table, called a routing table, which contains all the information a router needs in order to decide which line to export the message to. At a later stage in the course, we'll learn about how these routing tables are constructed and how a router learns them. The second function of the Internet Core is the ability to transmit messages between routers so that each router passes the message to the router next to it, and it also continues the process, creating a full course from sender to receiver. The messages skip between routers until they reach the destination predefined during send-off. Another alternative, called circuit switching, establishes a connection between two points at the beginning, keeping it open for the session between them. This alternative involves a connection setup, a process of connection establishment, where resources from the hosts and the router-managed connecting lines themselves are allocated for the session between these two points. Each line can handle a number of such sessions. For example, in this diagram, each line has a maximum of 4 such sessions. And each router on the line manages an organized table which defines an identifier for each session and the channel on the line dedicated to that session. In this type of communication, no data is shared between different sessions, and performance of factors such as speed and bandwidth are assured for the entire length of the session. If no data is transmitted in that session, but it didn't disconnect, the channel will be maintained. Usually, circuit switching is used in telephone networks. So what's better, circuit switching, or what's called packet switching, where every packet is sent online with a routing algorithm running on it in the routers? Each method has its own advantages and disadvantages. Different types of communications require different methods. Packet switching advantages are simple. There is no time-consuming connection setup. The resources are shared with different communication types. A line going down drops all communication, and the loads are distributed. That means this method is great for transmitting information which is sent at intermittent time intervals. So how do we use this method in transmissions that need to be steady in order not to damage the services, such as video? Usually by accumulating early data at the endpoints so the user receives the data in as fluid a manner as possible. In this unit, we learned of two functions of the Internet Core, packet switching and circuit switching, and looked at the differences between them. In the next unit, we'll look at the architecture of the Internet Core.